Welcome to the T-minus 60 series of videos. In this video, we will briefly go over how to reduce a buck converter's transient response. Going through the stages of a typical well-damped transient response for a converter, there will often be an initial spike at the output current load step. The spike is due to the ESR of the capacitors, and the equation to approximate the size of the spike can be seen on the left. This spike is not affected by the frequency response. It is more straightforward to fix as the step can only be reduced by reducing the ESR of our output capacitors. After this spike, the frequency response of the converter will overshoot or undershoot depending on the direction of the load step and will slowly curve off to a maximum height. This height can be approximated by the equation on the top left. The overshoot/undershoot will then return to its original value. While the equation shown is an approximation, it does give insight to what will reduce the overshoot and undershoot of a converter for a given load step. One can either increase the switching frequency of the converter or the output capacitance of the converter. Increasing the switching frequency is not always an option, as designs often have switching frequency as a parameter that is unable to be changed. Capacitance is more common to decrease overshoot and undershoot, but does have the downside of increasing the size of the converter. One additional way that the converter can decrease the size of the overshoot/undershoot is increasing the crossover frequency of the converter. This is because the time it takes the frequency response of the converter to reach the maximum overshoot or undershoot value is around 1 divided by the crossover frequency. Since the crossover frequency determines the speed of the response, increasing the crossover frequency will often decrease the transient response. The only downside to this is the crossover frequency can only be increased a certain amount before losing phase margin in a design which would be undesirable. In summary, there is a parasitic spike caused by the ESR that needs to be taken into account, as well as three different options that can reduce the amount of overshoot or undershoot that the design has, each of them with specific downsides.